Fishin' Affliction. Hello.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and old Rusty's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, and don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Man, and we've got it bad.
We've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here.
Well, rise and shine, it's Fishin' Affliction time, and thank you for tuning in this morning time as we continue our salute to the Trout Warriors, these true American heroes that love to catch the trout that the state of Tennessee releases. And right now, it's time to meet the oldest member of the Trout Warriors, Mr. Walter Coot.
Walter, what are we doing in this vehicle?
Keeping warm.
How come we got to keep warm? How cold is it outside?
I think it's about 25.
It is 25.
Yeah.
And we are here for the trout release down here at Shelby Park.
Yep.
And now my understanding is that you are the senior member.
Yep. I'm 91 years old.
Served in World War II.
Yep.
Well, I sincerely appreciate your service to our country.
Not many of us World War II veterans left.
No.
And I is the only two in this bunch.
That's right. And this whole trout warrior scenario got started how many years ago?
Oh, good God. Ed, how long have we been fishing for these trouts? 10, 15 years, isn't it?
Well, 10, 11 years, 12 years.
Yeah.
That's great. And come rain, snow, cold, heat, whatever, here we are.
Yep, we make it.
Now, let me tell you something. There's two other men right here that are in this vehicle with us that are part of the Trout Warriors. And individually, they have said who's going to catch the most and the first. And I don't want to give it away, but would you like to go on record on who's going to catch the first one and the most today?
I wouldn't say, because that George is lucky and so is Ian.
What do you think of that, Ed?
Well, after that good chuckle, it was time to get ready because the hatchery truck had arrived and it was time to dump a whole bunch of trout into Shelby Park. And the guys, well, they were anxious and so was I.
John, what's coming down the road?
The fishery.
You getting what's going to put the trout on the end of the line? Guaranteed?
Guaranteed.
What's
Panther Martin.
Panther Martins, that's right.
That's right.
What's coming down the road? The trout's coming down the road?
Yeah, they're fixing to bring them down right now.
Let's go get them. George?
Hey.
What are we needing? We need some fish, don't we?
Needs a whole bunch of fish and a little warm weather.
They're putting them way back over yonder, man.
They're coming on down through here. They'll be down here in a minute.
Sometimes they start biting right away. Other times they'll
just never know.
A lot of times they're kind of shocked. They won't bite for a couple hours.
Really?
Yeah.
Never know.
You never know. Sometimes they'll start biting as soon as they put them in.
It takes them a while.
Well, it looks like John's already fired off a couple casts out there.
Well, as the guys get ready and the trout get stocked, let's visit with the big dog and Doug Markham, Region 2 Information and Education Coordinator for the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
Well, guys, we're sitting here with my old buddy Doug Markham.
Rest
and we're going to pitch you the ball a little bit on the and let you tell us a little bit about the Trout Warriors, which is kind of like a deal we did earlier in the year. where we did the Wounded Warriors, which were veterans coming back from the Afghanistan, or you know, some of the local guys coming back 101st, and we did a tournament with them. But you all have a thing you do with the Trout Warriors. You mind tell us about that.
It's a little different than that, but it's got the same kind of folks. Only these guys, y'all were really nice and took care of the guys that were still pretty young and coming back from Iraq, and that's a wonderful thing y'all did. The Trout Warriors, in this case, they follow our trucks around, our winter trout truck. We stock in the winter time. We put tens of thousands of trout in local waters, Rusty, that you'd normally catch bass in. But in the winter, they get cold enough to put trout in. And these guys follow us around. We got World War II veterans, we got Korean veterans, Vietnam veterans, some of the greatest guys I've ever met in my life, and they'll tell you stories all day long about their time in the war. And you just wonder, just you're amazed at how anybody had that kind of courage back to face all this stuff on Normandy Beach and everything else they did. But they are guys that love to fish. They appreciate that we're doing the program, and we appreciate them.
That's a great program, man. I mean, and I'm sure they catch the fire out of them, don't they?
They're the best fishermen out there. They're the best fishermen. There's a couple of them that if you want to see what's biting on that day, you look at them. You follow what they're doing. If some days it's those little inline spinners, some days it's Berkeley Power eggs or salmon eggs, corn, whatever. Often it's those little inline spinners, though, and if you watch a couple of them, see what they're doing, go up and talk to them, you'll be catching a limit of fish. Not as quick as they do, but you'll get your limit eventually.
Well, folks, we'll be right back with some fish in action with the Trout Warriors there in the wilds of Shelby Park. And speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild, your pictures in the wild, brought to you by Express Hollandsave. Your home for low price, self-serve, auto parts, saving you money.
Well, folks, I've got a few pictures I wanted to share with you from my Bushnell game camera. And these are just awesome pictures of deer in the snow and at all times of the day. These two pictures right here are at 4:30 in the morning. And this very last picture, well, it is just beautiful. I like to call it Two Doe in the Snow on Christmas Day. What a great picture from that Bushnell game camera. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to check out the picture galleries there at fishandaffliction.com and send us those pictures, because maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the Wild, your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by Express Hollandsave. Your home for low price, self-serve, auto parts, saving you money.
It's kind of like this, all over, like that.
Yeah, maybe kind of like if you kind of steady, and if you pop it a little bit, you know.
There's no way I'm going to do that.
I believe it's like this.
Yeah, it's kind of like this.
It's like this. Then it's going like this.
No way.
Kind of like this.
The sexy swimmer, it's got action you can't believe until you see it.
I'm kind of liking this.
Big Dawg, where do you go when you need a gigantic selection of used auto parts at great prices?
Where everybody goes, Express Pull and Save in Laverne, Tennessee.
Conveniently located, Express Pull and Save offers a huge and continually updated inventory of vehicles for your automotive needs. Their simple, state-of-the-art customer service terminal will help you locate the parts so you can pull and save. From exterior parts like bumpers, taillights, wheels, and rims, to those hard-to-find interior items such as switches, mirrors, and seats, the friendly and courteous staff of Express Pull and Save makes it so easy to pull and save, even if you're the big dog.
Hey, big dog.
What?
Pull and Save's on that side of the fence.
But don't you think these will look good on the Ranger?
Express Pull and Save, your home for low price, self-serve auto parts.
Smyrna Ready Mixed is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, a professional home builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has all your concrete solutions.
With several locations in the Middle Tennessee area to service you, SRM offers a wide variety of concrete mix designs, admixtures, reinforcing products, aggregates, and much more to meet the requirements of any construction project that you have. From the biggest to the littlest, SRM is here to service you with unmatched quality and service. SRM, serving you with integrity and professionalism.
Tournament Trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM Smyrna Ready Mix, serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, here's the results of the very first tournament of the year, Mike's Saturday Morning Tournament, held on January 1st, 2011 at Percy Priest. Now, first place with 9.21 pounds was Mr. Ricky Lax. Second place was Mr. Mickey Beck with 8.10 pounds. And it was those two men that had first and second big fish, with Ricky catching one that was 5.45 pounds and Mickey catching one that was 4.71 pounds, good enough for second big fish. Thanks to Anderson Marine for providing that information, and congratulations to the winners. Folks, you can send your tournament results to info@fishandaffliction.com, and be sure to check out all the tournament trail links there at fishandaffliction.com so you can keep up with all of those who are on the trail. Thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for being the sponsor of the Fishin' Affliction Tournament Trail. And now, back to Fishin' Affliction. Well, folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and our salute to the Trout Warriors. And when the state of Tennessee releases these trout, there's no doubt that you're going to have a great opportunity to meet some true American heroes. And be sure to take the time to meet these folks, like this gentleman right here, Mr. John Sales. John, we are standing in the cold, cold air, Shelby Park.
You're right.
And you are doing something today because the state of Tennessee is releasing some trout.
Trout.
And do you normally come and do this?
Well, last year, year before last, right.
Did you? That's great. And tell me a little bit about your military background.
Well, I was in the Marine Corps from 66 to 68. Served two in Vietnam, got wounded twice. And just out here retired from the Postal Service, enjoying life.
I just want to come and tell you that we just appreciate you, and we just sincerely appreciate what you've done for this country. I just want to come shake your hand and just say hello to you.
All right.
Now, you ain't leaving, are you?
I'm going to get here and get
it. You're going to get warm, and they're going to catch all the trout.
I'm going to watch and see who else catches. That's right, before I start.
All right, John Sales, it's nice to meet you. Okay. Thank you so much for taking time for me.
Okay.
Now, there seems to be a little discrepancy amongst the Trout Warriors right here. Wait, we got somebody ain't listening to some advice. Is that right? John, you ain't going to put it down there, are you?
No. Look at him jumping. Look at him jumping right by my body. It's only 1 foot deep.
You sure you don't need to drop that another 2 feet?
Nope.
What do you think, Ed?
Right there. Watch him. He'll take it.
He ain't going to pay no attention to you, would he?
George, how you making it?
Hey, Ed. Getting a little chilly. Ed, you done caught a fish?
No, man. I've caught cold fingers. I'm going to go to Starbucks, y'all.
Well, folks, as you can tell, it's a cold, cold day there at Shelby Park. 25-degree air temperature with a wind chill factor of below 15 degrees. Now, that's cold. And the trout just weren't biting. Now, the beauty of what the state of Tennessee does this time of year is that they schedule these trout releases pretty close together. So all you have to do is wait a couple days and be at the next trout release, which is exactly what we did when the state of Tennessee released a bunch of trout there at Nicest Mills on Percy Priest. And this time the Trout Warriors and a bunch of other folks knew it was time to catch their limits. You ready to catch them? Well, it's about to happen, isn't it? Hey, it's about to happen. You ready to catch him? You ready? Now, folks, Mr. Red Lane's got a big smile on his face because he knows that the trout are coming. You see, when they get dumped off the truck here, a lot of those trout will swim downstream, but a lot of them will swim upstream, and that's where the Trout Warriors know that they're going to catch them. Now, don't be fooled into thinking that these fish are easy to catch, because they are not. It takes a lot of technique, a lot of knowledge to know which baits to use and when to use them. And nobody knows it better than the trout master himself, Mr. Ed Lane.
Who caught him, Ed? Who caught him? You did?
Yeah.
Well, folks, there's no doubt that everybody is starting to have a great time there at Nicest Mills catching those trout. And as we watch the fun, let's hear again from Doug Markham as he shares a little history about this great program.
Doug, can you give us a little history on how the program ended up getting started?
Be glad to, Rusty. It was started in Middle Tennessee by a guy named Frank Fisk and also Tim Cleveland. They're both biologists. They're big into the streams. And they just had the idea that it would be a way to get people involved that maybe normally don't fish for trout. The first thought was it was going to be an urban program, but it's actually a little beyond an urban program. We do bring the trout closer to a lot more people because we take them and put them in water that's normally hot. It's Percy Priestel water. You can't, mm-hmm. Trout won't live there in the summertime, but right now in the winter, they do great. But those guys thought about it. I got their heads together and met with the hatchery folks at Delhalla National Hatchery, at Flintville Hatchery, and some other hatcheries, and everybody agreed that it would be a good idea. Started about a decade ago, and it's expanded ever since. Even this year, we're adding two or three more streams to it across the state, and it just gets more popular and more popular.
Well, I'm going to tell you, man, we had the opportunity to do a little trout fishing early in the year on Delhalla, and the thing that really is amazing to me is how deep. Once the trout get up to 3, 4, 5 pounds, how deep those fish will actually stay?
They will. You know, the trout in Delhalla, and I'm glad you brought that up, because there's trout in Delhalla and Caney Fork River and those places that are there all the time. And so that's kind of the idea with this. These trout we release aren't going to be that big, but they are going to be those fish that we hope get people interested in trout fishing, mm-hmm. and that later they become more like a Rusty and a Dan, and they go fishing for bigger fish and go to other places and catch these bigger fish like at Delhalla. It's amazing what's at Delhalla Lake. Once these guys start learning how to catch them, take what they're learning to a place like Delhalla and start catching these trophies, then we got them hooked for life, and that's what we want to do.
Well, folks, there's no doubt that the state of Tennessee is sure taking care of us anglers by providing such a great program that so many of us are enjoying. And each and every one of these anglers out here are extremely grateful for the efforts of the state of Tennessee and the TWRA and all the hard-working folks that make it happen, like Doug Markham and everybody else associated with this fine program. And our hats are off to each and every one of you. Well, folks, in a few moments, we'll be back with some more fish in action. But right now, let's go see what Miss Vic has got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and so far this winter, we have already had several cold days. And there's nothing I like better on a cold day than some homemade chili. And that's what we're going to cook today. It's my cold day chili. You will need 2 pounds of ground beef or turkey, 2 cans of kidney beans, 2 cans of Rotel, 1 can of tomato sauce, 4 tablespoons of minced onion, 2 garlic cloves minced, 2 tablespoons of chili powder, salt and pepper to taste, and shredded cheddar cheese. First, we're gonna brown our beef in a skillet. After draining your beef, we're gonna add it to the crock pot. Next, we'll add our kidney beans. Now we're gonna add our Rotel. Now we'll add our tomato sauce. Now our minced onions and chili powder. And last, our garlic. Now we're gonna cook this in the crock pot, and you can either cook it on low for 8 to 10 hours or on high for 4 hours. After sprinkling on some cheddar cheese, it's time to sit down and enjoy this cold day chili. You can find this recipe at fishinaffliction.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
Hey, what do you think about these? Shaw Grigsby likes these, but Denny Brower looks awesome in these. You know, a lot of people don't know that Strike King is the number one importer of packaged polarized sunglasses in the whole entire country. I've seen Mark Davis wear these, and I like them a lot. They're awesome. But you know what? Me? I have got to have my Monsters.
Big Dawg, I've got the need for outdoor radio. I need fishing reports. I need to know what's going on in the world of the outdoors. Where do I go?
You need to listen to Doug Markham.
On 99.7 WTN every Saturday from 5 to 7 a.m. and you might even hear this too.
For hunters only, brought to you by Fishin' Affliction. For those who've got it bad, both on the water and in the woods.
Well, folks, this here is David Burns, friend of Fishin' Affliction pro staffer Catfish. And David was able to get some great footage of a recent deer hunt that he experienced. While hunting off the ground, David was able to see this 8-point coming through the woods off at a distance. And after a little bit, that 8-point got into an opening. And that's when David had the opportunity to harvest him.
Folks, we hunted a little different area this morning, and this young deer came in early and caught me off guard. He came in kind of on the back right-hand corner of me. I couldn't get a good shot on him, couldn't get the camera on him real good. I let him walk on off, and he went kind of back the same path that he came in on and looped on around the bottom side of the ridge and came up in a little better angle for me that second time.
Congratulations to David Burns for a great hunt. And now, folks, back to Fishin' Affliction.
It's time for Fishin' 101, brought to you by Maryville Middle Bass Club. Now here's Carla.
Thanks, guys. As you know, fishing off the bank or the dock is fun, but nothing beats fishing off a boat. But there are some safety issues to keep in mind when you do. Make sure that you follow all boating laws and requirements. Check the capacity plate of your boat so that you don't overload it. You should wear a life jacket, especially when fishing alone. Slow down when approaching other fishing boats. Be careful not to cause a large wake. Also, be aware of fishing lines as they may be out to the sides of a boat or trolling behind it. And please don't toss used fishing line into the water as it can be dangerous to the wildlife and to boat propellers. Remember, when you're on the water, you're a boat operator first and an angler second. One simple mistake can cause a lot of problems, so have fun when you're on the water, but also be safe. I'm Carla, and this has been Fishing 101 with the Maryville Middle School Bass Club.
Folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction and our salute to the Trout Warriors. And this portion of the show is brought to you by the ever-powerful DECA Gel Series Batteries and Kistler Rods. Fishing never felt so good. And now it's time for a little more fishing fun with the Trout Warriors. John, that's a dandy, huh?
Number one.
Number one. Hey, that's great. What number is that one, Ed?
Six, I think.
Oh, I tell you what. Well, as we watch Mr. Ed Lane put another trout on his stringer, let's hear one more time from Doug Markham as he shares his thoughts about the Trout Warriors and this great program.
The Winter Trout Program is a wonderful program, one, because it gets a lot of people out fishing, and two, it gets us out, the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency, to meet them. We get an idea of what they're thinking and what they like and what they want. For me, meeting the Trout Warriors in particular has been one of the best things that's ever happened to me at the Wildlife Agency. One, because the guys really love to fish, but two, because they're heroes. These guys are some serious heroes. They served in World War II. They served in Korea and Vietnam. They're very brave people that have, somehow miraculously stayed in great shape. They're in their 80s, a lot of them, or several of them, but yet they come out fishing everywhere we go. I don't care if it's 70 degrees, we get one of those odd winter days, or if it's 10 degrees, you're gonna see Walt and Ed and John and some of the other ones. They're gonna be out there, George, Big George we call him. They'll be out there fishing, and they will always catch more fish than anybody. If you ever see them and you recognize them from watching this program, go talk to them, ask them what they're fishing with, and then ask them about some more stories, because they're always willing to talk. This program will stock close to 90,000 fish in the winter. It's been going on for a decade, and I hope it goes on for many more decades after this, and we keep on bringing out the veterans, and they can bring out their children. But it's a great program, and they're great people. We talk about the Trout Warriors a lot, but this program, this winter trout program, is for everybody. And we're stocking new areas, and folks are always trying to, are always needing to learn about the new areas, and sometimes it's difficult to let them know. So shows like this, tnwildlife.org, that's the website for TWA. You can go out there and learn where we're going, and just go. Go get your proper licenses. You need a trout license, of course, your regular license and a trout license, or if you have a sportsman's license, you're covered. But the program is for everyone. It's not just for trout warriors. And we've had kids out there that were 3 or 4 years old, all the way up to one of the Trout Warriors, Walt, and we know he's right at 90 years old. We want everything in between, male, female, everything. It's for all of you, and we're going to keep doing it a long time. The limit is 7 fish a day. There's no size limit, and we urge everybody to take them home, because they're not going to live into the summer, okay? This is putting them in places that are going to be warm come May and June, so take them home with you. Get you a good trout recipe and cook them, but tnwildlife.org, best place to see where we're stocking.
Yes, sir.
Who caught the first 7? What's John doing right now?
He's getting some of my power bait.
Oh, I like it, John.
Look at me.
Well, folks, I hope you've enjoyed our tribute to the Trout Warriors, these true American heroes that love fishing, they love life, and they love this country. And be sure to go up and shake the hand of one of these fine men and women that have sacrificed so much for us. And tune in next week, because there's no doubt.
We got that fish in the question.
Folks, thank you so much for tuning in this week to Fishin' Affliction. We sincerely appreciate your time. And thank you so much to our sponsors, as they keep us going. Be sure to tune in next week to Fishin' Affliction, because there's no doubt.
Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that Fishin' Affliction.
And folks, don't forget to go to fishinaffliction.com to the online store, because that's where you'll find your favorite single episodes of Fishin' Affliction for only $5. Or any of the season box sets for only $19.95. All of that at our online store. And
folks, if you want to contact us here at Fishin' Affliction, you can contact us at rusty@fishinaffliction.com or
dan@fishinaffliction.com.
We would love to hear from you, so send us a line when you get a chance.
Man, and we've got it bad.
Rusty's catching today.
I'll bet you anything.
Here, watch it. Hey, like hey.
A striking bait. Let's go.
Ain't nothing safe around me.